I have a good one for you today. So I was inserting some nuts into my bird's trunk when all of a sudden,
a customer came in.
I was putting some steel insert nuts into the sheet metal of the T-Bird's trunk floor when my hoses came.
Check it out. Bitmoe Squad 98, Raw Deluxe. Check it out, yo. I'll be the street kid, the brother your mama frequent. Put y'all people on if y'all know how to keep a secret. When I get money, you know I like to keep it. How I get money, others are trying to peep it. Flip mode, be winners you want to form a team with. To make money figures, the ones that plot the scheme.
Amplifiers is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds.
28 3/4. I grabbed some shallow cups for the rear. We got some hoses, some 15 footers, some 3 footers, and some 6 footers. These are the fittings that will go into the cylinders. There's a couple other miscellaneous fittings in here, switches. And this is some 9 conductor wire we could run straight up to the switches.
I have 2 simple goals for today. My first goal is to hook my goddamn hoses up, run the lines from my cylinders to my pumps. My second goal is to register the Thunderbird. It turns out the paperwork's bad. I was all excited putting my fittings on, completing my goals for the day. Took a goddamn lunch break. Went over to AAA because I use AAA for all my DMV transactions because it includes a AAA discount on head gaskets. It's an added bonus. The bitch said, "Where'd you get this car?" I said, "What car?" And I ran. I'm over here putting hydraulics on the bank's car. So I called Wells Fargo and asked them if they would like 6 batteries or 8. I'm still gonna bend it in half.
Done.
I know I had a lean bank, but I didn't know I had a bank lean too. Now I need to perform an illegal VIN swap on YouTube in front of millions, thousands, a couple hundred people.
Doug.
You may find yourself living in a shotgun shack.
Now I find myself convincing my dad to drive me to Culver City with a bag of tools and an envelope full of cash. I overdrew my bank account to get cash out. Turns out it's a Wells Fargo account. The same bank with that put the lien on the title. My balls are so big they call me Bell's Largo.
Doug, right now it's not time for this. Right now it's not the time.
I'm a banker now.
It doesn't matter what you do.
Parking lot oil change in case.
Pretty porked right there.
Oh, go figure. Look at that.
I was about to kill myself when I got a Craigslist notification on my phone. A great deal popped up on a white 95 Thunderbird with low miles. I mean, I was in the bathtub with the jackhammer up my ass plugged in with my finger on the surge protector power switch. You don't want a power surge going to your jackhammer. With a ball gag in my mouth. I flipped the switch anyway, it didn't kill me.
Can I help you?
And you may ask yourself, how do I work this? And you may ask yourself, where is that large automobile? And you may tell yourself, this is not my beautiful house. And you may tell yourself, this is not my beautiful wife.
This is a single-owner pearl-white Thunderbird with 33,000 original miles, gray interior, a porked front fender, premium sound, service records, both factory keyless entry remotes, the manual. This thing is fully loaded. It just has a slightly blown head gasket.
Doug, my patience for you is very short today.
Looks like the alternator was replaced, new spark plug wires. They have some service records. Mass airflow sensor's been replaced. This runs good. Drove good on the freeway.
This T-Bird actually runs really well and it's white. I'm not trying to be bird racist, but this is gonna be a couple steps back, but a huge step forward in the long run if we still plan to paint the car white. Maybe we should paint it brown. What do you guys think?
Interior looks really good.
Could be like a Mexican bird. I'm not trying to be a bird racist, right?
Are you done so you can shut the fuck up, you fucking sorry ass?
This seat looks great. That seat's a little bit worn. It's a little bit sun bleached like the other one.
Here we have our Ford Audio Systems cassette demonstration tape. Okay. About halfway listened through. Spare keys with working remotes. Awesome factory. So here's the situation with this. Beautiful.
It's almost done.
I kind of porked myself because I started putting fittings on and we sucked the fluid out of these cylinders and now I need to swap it over so this isn't drivable. I need to swap the suspension, put fluid back in the cylinders, cap them off, get this fucking thing out of here. We need to swap the alternator over. We'll put this one's alternator back on. Chrome one's going on here. This replacement alternator, we'll just save it.
My goal for this week is to get all the good parts swapped over to the new car, so like this never happened. That way if one of my viewers skipped a week, they're gonna come back and be, oh, he painted the car, look at him go. Goddamn, he didn't waste any time. Well, only the true fans will know that I wasted a little bit of time. Even though that rebuild was pretty goddamn easy. Oh, that? Piece of cake. I started a new charity called Free Head Gaskets for people with shitty loans. All my friends are welcome.
What's really cool is stuff like this. This rubber trim is really going to help prevent door dings. Oh, fuck. Crap.
Right now I'm focusing on getting the front suspension swapped over in both cars and the front cylinders capped back off, that way both cars are movable.
My friend Doug told me one thing.
I learned two things from this whole ordeal. One, there's no such thing as a free car. If life hands you a lemon, steal its airbag module and its front fender and give it back. And two, I'm a mechanical repair genius. Who else have you seen swap a head gasket and rebuild a motor with the motor still in the car, polish the crankshaft with a goddamn shoelace, get the car running, and give it back to his friend like a goddamn hot potato? You're it. Hope it makes it back. All of my head gasket repairs come with an optional extended warranty for 30,000 miles. For $20,000. I'll fix it if it breaks. I don't give a shit.
For 20 grand?
This bolt was loose as shit. Sometimes I impress myself. You know, I knew I was gonna have to go back in here. Now we got an ABS light. We have a flashing airbag light. Must be something wrong in here. The front's done. Because I designed quick swap front hydro struts. Just in case this type of shit would happen.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
This car runs perfectly, but we have an ABS light, a flashing airbag light, and turns out the odometer doesn't work.
this morning I'd like to try to clear these lights and swap over the dash panel, gauge cluster, and alternator. Use Wells Fargo's airbag sensors to diagnose my goddamn airbag light. If I need to. But not Bank of America. I close my account because their customer service sucks. It's poor customer.
It's not the time for this.
I was able to clear the airbag light, but for some reason my firm ride light is stuck on.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
This morning the T-Bird passed its smog inspection. It's officially registered. Brand new plates. After I swapped over the parts, I went home, pressure washed it, so as of right now, it's somewhat clean, fully registered and drivable, and all of the parts are swapped over except for the rear cylinders and the insert nuts for the pump rack. This thing really needs a paint job, but for now, we need to borrow the fender from the brown T-Bird, paint it, and then buff the rest of the paint out so it looks decent enough to drive around while we finish up the stereo system. Just when I thought an in-vehicle crankshaft servicing was the easiest job I've ever done, this little swap job presents itself. Just when you thought this deal couldn't get any sweeter, now my odometer works. And only reads 14,000 miles. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. We'll continue right where we left off on Thursday at 7 a.m. Come back every Monday and Thursday at 7 a.m. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think about today's episode. I'll see you guys next time. Support Amplified by purchasing iPad dash kits and Soundman merch from soundmanca.com. Take your fabrication skills to the next level with the tools and trainings available from mobilesolutions-usa.com. Check upcoming training dates at mobilesolutions-usa.com/training. Go to ctsounds.com to get a discount on quality car stereo equipment with coupon code SOUNDMAN. See what kind of stereo system you could put together for your budget at ctsounds.com.